In the world of military aviation, the race for air supremacy is heating up. For decades, air dominance has often been associated with Western technology, particularly the United States. However, recently, the world was shocked by reports that China has successfully flown its sixth-generation fighter jet, a major step that appears to surpass the United States' still-in-development NGAD, Next Generation Air Dominance Program. China's sixth-generation fighter jet, tentatively referred to by analysts as the J-36, is the culmination of years of technological development. If the claims are true, China is not only demonstrating its technological prowess, but also challenging the West's hegemony in the military aerospace field. The sixth-generation fighter jet is a major leap from previous generations, such as the F-22 Raptor and F-35 Lightning II, which are fifth generation. The sixth-generation jet is designed to be a smarter, more lethal, and much harder to detect air platform. Some of its key features include artificial intelligence, AI, capabilities, integration with autonomous drone fleets, more advanced stealth technology, next-generation electronic warfare systems, and the use of high-energy weapons such as lasers. If reports of China's sixth-generation fighter jet are accurate, it would signal that Beijing has successfully overcome a technological challenge previously thought only achievable by the United States. China's success in developing a sixth-generation fighter jet did not happen overnight. It is the result of massive investment in research, development, and upgrading of its aerospace industry capabilities over the past two decades. 1. The evolution of the J-20. China's experience with the J-20, its fifth-generation fighter jet, laid an important foundation in the development of the technology. The J-20, although initially doubted by many Western analysts, has now proven to be a fighter jet capable of competing with the F-22 and F-35. This success gives China a foothold to move further towards the sixth generation. 2. Integrated Research and Development, R&D. China has a unique ability to align military research with the civilian sector. Technology companies such as Huawei and DJI, which are well known in the global consumer market, also contribute to the development of artificial intelligence, communications, and autonomous control systems used in military projects. 3. Stable political and budgetary support. Unlike the United States, which has to face political obstacles in approving military budgets, China has full control over its defense policy. This allows Beijing to focus on strategic priorities without distraction. 1 factor that is often overlooked in this discussion is the cost aspect. The development of a sixth-generation fighter jet is not only about technical capability, but also about budget efficiency. On this point, China seems to have a significant advantage. 1. China's budget strategy. China is known for its aggressive but controlled approach to military development. Thanks to its extensive domestic supply chain and low-cost labor, they are able to keep production costs low. In addition, the Chinese government has full control over their technology and aerospace industries, allowing them to reduce bureaucratic obstacles and ensure efficiency in resource allocation. It is estimated that the budget for China's sixth-generation fighter jet program is much lower than the US NGAD project. This means that Beijing can develop more units without sacrificing quality or combat capability. 2. The cost challenge of the NGAD project. On the other hand, the US NGAD program faces a major challenge related to cost. From the beginning, the development of cutting-edge technology in the US has often been accompanied by a bloated budget. For example, the F-22 Raptor, developed in the late 1990s, cost $143 million to produce, while the F-35, while cheaper, still costs around $80 million per unit. The NGAD is expected to be significantly more expensive, with an estimated price tag of $300 million or more per unit. That doesn't include the cost of developing support systems such as autonomous drones designed to work alongside the jet, as well as infrastructure upgrades and pilot training and... 3. Long-term effects. This cost differential could have a major impact in the long term. If China can produce a sixth-generation fighter jet in large numbers at a lower cost, it could distribute the asset more widely, creating a numerical advantage that the United States will struggle to match. Meanwhile, the US military's ballooning budget could create political and economic pressures, especially if the NGAD project falls short of expectations. 5. If China's claims about its sixth-generation fighter jet are true, then the world is facing a major shift in the military power landscape. The difference in production costs is one of the key factors that will influence this dynamic. A cheaper yet advanced jet would allow China to produce in large numbers, giving them strategic flexibility across multiple theaters of conflict. Meanwhile, the US must find a way to control the cost of the NGAD without sacrificing its technological edge. Will it be able to create a fighter jet that is not only superior, but also cost-efficient? Only time will tell. 6. The technological competition between China and the United States is not only about sophistication, but also efficiency and sustainability. China, with its aggressive budget strategy and full control of its industry, seems to have the advantage at the moment. However, the United States still has a chance to catch up, especially if they can reduce the cost of developing NGAD. The sixth-generation fighter jet is not only a symbol of advanced technology, but also a strategic tool that determines the map of global power. China has made great strides by launching this aircraft earlier than many expected. Meanwhile, the United States faces a major challenge in balancing innovation with cost efficiency through their NGAD program. The question now is, can the United States catch up before China truly consolidates their advantage, or is the world witnessing the beginning of a new era where air dominance is no longer dominated by the West?